Go and grab your Beware merchandise today. There are t-shirts, sweatshirts, phone cases, and more, all with the link down in the description below. You do not want to miss out. What's up, guys? It's Carson back here on Toxic Gaming today with week 7 of the Meme League. It's been a little while for the Meme League stuff, but basically this happened a little while back. I had stuff going on with my family and everything, so we couldn't actually battle this ourselves. For this week, we were going up against Omega Jolteon and the Chicago Caracastas. But we actually, thanks to some good things, Pippo was able to take my team for me and battle for me with this. I was just out of town and we had no way to get this done before the actual game deadline. So Pippo was battling in my place for this, which I'm okay. Shout out to him for battling in my place. His links and Omega Jolteon's links will be down below as well. So I don't remember if Pippo uploaded this. I doubt he did. But if you want to see Omega's side of the battle, you can go ahead and see that. There will also be, like, right now, a little timestamp here on the video somewhere on the screen, you know, whatever, for you guys to go to if you want to skip the little team builder part here in the beginning and just go right into the battle. If you want to do that, by all means, you can. No threat there or anything, or nothing bad there for doing that. But anyway, let me pull up the team, I gave my exact team that I had planned to bring to Pippo, so he played with the team that I built and everything. I just couldn't actually do the thing. But Omega Jolteon's draft as a whole was Megalop Bunny, Mew, which is one of Z users, Crocodile, Azumarill, which was a Super Z user, Z Roserade, Swellow, Bronzong, Dredagon, Rotom, Rigorotom, Beautifly, and Phanpy, each for 1 point as well. And then finally his meme pick was Braxen. Well, if Phanpy couldn't be a meme pick, he had a meme pick in Braxen, so I guess that's what it was. But for this match, I decided to bring One Man Band, OMB, or Mega Manectric, with Volt Switch, Hidden Power Ice, Overheat, and Thunderbolt. Basically just Max. Was kind of building this team on the fly when we had to do it. Next up was the Hurricane Pidgeot with Choice Scarf, because I believe I had to have this to be able to outspeed Megalop. You have Choice Scarf on Pidgeot. But with Brave Bird, Facade, U-Turn, and Frustration, just in case you tried to burn me with the with the Mew or Rotom, I had Facade to be able to do some damage with that. Frustration, really, for everything else normal types need to do. Next, we had Roman, our Banded Zygarde, with 1,000 Arrows, Outrage, E-Speed, and Glare. 68 in HP, 252 in Attack, and Adamant, and then 188 in Speed. Really, with this, I believe this was, like, supposed to be outspeeding everything but Megalop, or outspeeding even Megalop. I can't remember what Megalop's base speed is. But that's the speed we hit with Choice Band, and really, I felt like the best thing we needed was Choice Band E-Speeds in this match, like, especially with Azumarill having good old Aqua Jet and stuff. Choice Band E-Speeds could be really nice. I think I forgot to say the spread for Pidgeot, but he was 68 in HP, 252 in Attack, and then 188 in Speed with a Jolly Nature, basically hitting the same speed that Zygarde was. Next, we had Lesnar, or Jirachi, a Scarf Jirachi, with Iron Head, U-Turn, Zen Headbutt, and Healing Wish, 68 in HP, 252 in Attack, and then 196 in Speed, and Jolly Natured. I think I was planning on going triple Scarf in this, with Zygarde being Scarf, because all three Scarfers are the exact same base speed, but I think I'd accidentally clicked Band or something, I don't know. But really, Jirachi, again, try to outspeed that Megalop and hit it with something super hard. The Megalop was so scary that I feel like I kind of overprepped for it a little bit, but at the same time, I felt like if I didn't overprep for it, then, like, there was no way for me to, like, perfectly prep, I felt, for it. It was either over or under, so I figured I'd rather go over for it. Next, we have Tristratus, our Clefable, with Life Orb, Calm Mind, Soft Boiled, Moonblast, and Shadow Ball. 252 in HP, 180 in Bold in Defense, and then 48 in Special Defense, and about 28 in Speed, just in case of a Speed Creep from anything. Basically, I thought if I can get a Calm Mind up, Calm Mind or 2 up, then Moonblast and Shadow Ball can do a good amount to his entire team. Especially as we see on screen, like, that does a good amount to everything that he brought, bar, I believe, Azumarill. But that's kind of what Clefable was meant to do here. Basically be mid-game tanky or early-game damage so that one of the other Scarfers can clean up. And then finally, we have Tajiri, our Toxpex, with Rocky Helmet and Regenerator, Scald, Recover, Sludge Wave, and Toxic Spikes, 200 in HP, 252 Bold in Defense, 4 in Special Attack, and then 52 in Special Defense. Basically, the thing with Talk Specs was I wanted to get that Rocky helmet damage on Lop Bunny as soon as possible, and really Talk Specs is my was my switch into Mega Lop every single time. Really, if I could burn Mega Lop with Scald, like that's really the one thing I wanted to be able to burn with Scald. But after that, I wanted to try to set up T Spikes to toxic the Mew down, to toxic Azumarill because burns from Scald. I don't think that you could burn Scald and Azumarill. Maybe you can. I don't know. But basically, just get the toxic wearing down on Mew was like the biggest thing, and I felt T Spikes could actually help set up with that. And then Sludge Wave was, I believe, for Azumarill as well, hitting that neutrally. So that's kind of what we were going for with that. Basic ass stock specs, just trying to get that extra damage from the Rocky helmet and everything. But we're just, for those of you who are just joining us, we're actually gonna get onto the battle here. Again, shout out to Pippo before I start this for actually being able to play this. I couldn't be here, so shout out to him for actually playing through this. Pippo's gonna lead off with Manectric, and Joltan's gonna lead off with good old Mew. He pulls the switch out right here, probably expecting the Volt Switch, and Pippo's gonna Mega Evolve. And we get trade Intimidates and actually went for the Volt Switch here. So good switch on Jolteon's part for that. He Pippo has to hard switch now out into Clefable on the knockoff. Sad that we lost our Life Orb this early, but it's kind of what we had to do rather than take Earthquakes. He goes out into his Bronzong as Pippo sets up the Calm Mind. Kind of what I wanted Clefable here to do. And then Shadow Balling this Bronzong and being able to 2-hit KO this thing was really nice. But I was not expecting Heavy Slam. I was expecting more of the Gyro Ball and stuff rather than Heavy Slam. So good little piece of tech on that for Omega Jolteon taking out Bronzong there. Pippo brings out Zygarde 50 or 10. Go Roman and Thousand Arrowsing things. Gets the crit on the Mew, which is super unfortunate for Omega Jolteon. That super sucks. But we actually get the second crit on Mew as well to be able to take out Mew. So like that really sucks, and I'm sorry about that, but it's nothing we could change with. I have to switch out here. Race switch out here with the Azumarill, and he goes for the Z Belly Drum. So, shout out to fuck me, right? Because basically after that, after Tajiri goes down here to the Bulldoze, I had nothing really for this, especially because of Aqua Jets. And I could see what Pippo was trying to do here with intimidating him down as much as he possibly could. But literally Aqua Jet sadly cleans up a lot of these mons. And after two Intimidates, maybe we could live in Aqua Jet, and no. So, even with the two Intimidates, this fucking thing is going to destroy us. He goes into Jirachi here, which can lives it very nicely, or kind of nicely. U-turns out, knows what's going to be able to probably beat this thing down at this level is a Banded E-Speed from Zygarde, and thankfully that Banded E-Speed was able to actually do the thing that needed to do. He goes into the Mega Lop here. And just Mega Evolving and going, we go right for the Banded E-Speed, get the damage we need to do, and he goes for the High Jump Kick and lands. Roman's gone. 10 times, Roman's gone. But the Jirachi comes in here, and we really can't do much at this point. He just goes into the Crooked Isle and easily just sits here and takes the Iron Heads for days after the Intimidate. Like, it was really, Iron Head was the only play, and it's like, we could flinch down things, we get one flinch, but like, we need like 3 or 4 flinches to really get this, game set up, but sadly, he knocks off the Choice Scarf and Lesnar will go down. So, again, like, this is a quick battle, and it's literally, I don't feel anything on Pippo's fault for how he played it. I definitely did not prep for Z Belly Drum, good old Azumarill. I was more afraid of the Mega Lop than I was really the Azumarill completely. Didn't even realize the thing got Bulldoze, so that was really cool to see. And then I guess I wasn't expecting Heavy Slam. I was expecting more Gyro Ball from Bronzong, just as usual. But hell, it wasn't, you know, it wasn't a 5, it wasn't a 6-0, it was a 4-0, so I'll take that. Thanks, like, seriously again to Pippo for being able to battle this for me. I'm really kind of mad I couldn't be here and battle it myself, but so sometimes life gets in the way. But again, shout out to Omega Jolteon and Thwin. Check out his links down below and everything, see his side of the battle. Check out Pippo's links to see everything he's done really in the Meme League as well. If you guys like what you see, go ahead and do that like and subscribe stuff at the end and everything. And at the very end of this video, there will be more videos for you guys to go right to if you're binging, I understand. There's more videos right there for you guys. But I'm gonna get up on out of here, so thank you guys for coming out. I'm Carson, this is Toxic Gaming, and as always, you guys stay toxic. We'll see you guys.